I hope you're desiring the presence of the Holy Ghost in your life. Amen. I hope that you are desiring each and everything that God has for you today.
Amen.
Did you come in expecting God to do something?
Yes. Amen.
Amen. 10 people. Okay, did you come in expecting God to do something?
Amen.
Amen. Thank God, thank God. He's already done something. He brought you here today. He brought us together in the fashion that he has. And thank God that he has, amen. Because it is a joy to be gathered together in the house of the Lord. If you got your Bible today, turn over to the book of 2 Samuel. 2 Samuel chapter 9. Very familiar scripture to some. Amen. Going to be teachy, preachy, preachy, teachy. Holy Ghost filled. You just going to have to listen.
Amen.
Amen. To the Word of God today. God's got something for each and every one here.
Amen.
Those who can and will stand in reverence to read God's Word when you find your place. 2 Samuel 9, verse 1 through 13. Turn to one side and say, God's got something for you today. God's got something for each and every one of us today. Amen. Now smile at the one beside you because you're not. All right. Well, good, good, good. You was already smiling. Praise God. If you wasn't, you should be, because if you're saved, we should be the happiest people on the face of the earth.
Amen.
Amen. 2 Samuel chapter 9 and verse 1. And David said, is there yet any that is left of the house of Saul, that I may show him kindness for Jonathan's sake? And there was of the house of Saul a servant whose name was Ziba. And when they had called him unto David, the king said unto him, art thou Ziba? And he said, thy servant is he. And the king said, is there not yet any of the house of Saul, that I may show the kindness of God unto him? And Ziba said unto the king, Jonathan hath yet a son, which is lame on his feet. And the king said unto him, where is he? And Ziba said unto the king, behold, he is in the house of Machir, the son of Emiel, in Lodabar. Then King David sent and fetched him out of the house of Machir, the son of Emiel, from Lodabar. Now, when Mephibosheth, everybody say Mephibosheth. The son of Jonathan, the son of Saul, was come unto David. He fell on his face and did reverence. And David said, Mephibosheth. And he answered, behold, thy servant. For David said unto him, fear not, for I will surely show thee kindness for Jonathan, thy father's sake, and will restore thee all the land of Saul, thy father, and thou shalt eat bread at my table continually. And he bowed himself and said, what is thy servant that thou shouldest look upon such a dead dog as I am? Then the king called to Ziba, Saul's servant, and said unto him, I have given unto thy master's son all that pertain to Saul and to all his house. Thou therefore and thy sons and thy servants shall till the land for him, and thou shalt bring in the fruits that thy master's son may have food to eat. But Mephibosheth, thy master's son, shall eat bread always at my table. Now Ziba had 15 sons and 20 servants. Then said Ziba unto the king, according to all that my lord the king hath commanded his servant, so shall thy servant do. For as Mephibosheth said the king, he shall eat at my table as one of the king's sons. And Mephibosheth had a young son whose name was Micah. And all that dwelt in the house of Ziba were servants unto Mephibosheth. So Mephibosheth dwelt in Jerusalem, for he did eat continually at the king's table and was lame on both his feet. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you today, God. We praise you for everything you give us. We just thank you for everything that you do. And God, we just pray, Father, that you'd let us just get something out of the Word today that you'd have us to get. We pray, Father, that there'd be one here today that's lost, that they're being saved, that there'd be one backslid, that they'll be reclaimed. We pray that nobody grieves the Spirit today, Lord. And Father, that we'll rejoice every Lord, knowing, God, that we can eat continually at your table. And God, we just pray, Father, that you'll guide and direct today. And God, that you'll touch each and every heart on an individual level. We'll give you all the glory. In Jesus' wonderful and holy name I pray. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Look at the one beside you and say, Mephibosheth. Say it one more time. I think some of us mispronounced. Amen. Now I want you to remember his name.
Right.
Name him because there's names in the Word of God. Everyone in there is very important.
Right.
Every name in there is important. We're going to be talking about a young man in the fellowship. Amen. We're going to be talking about him. But amen, we can relate him to us. We can relate him to our lives. Amen. Because the Bible does have practical application, does it not?
Yeah.
I love this account. This isn't a story. This is an account in the Word of God.
Right.
I hate to hear people say, well, Bible stories. Well, no, they're biblical accounts
right.
of real things that really happened. It's not a made-up story. It's not a fairy tale. Amen. It is history. It's a biblical account of things that happened.
Yeah.
Amen. Here. On this earth. It's a biblical account of things that happen that God wants us to know about, because if God didn't want us to know about it, it would not have made it into the Word of God.
Amen.
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 This is so important. You look back a little history of Mephibosheth. Amen. You look back, he's got crippled up in both legs. You have to look back, amen, unto 1 Samuel 31 and 2 Samuel chapter 1 if you want some details of it, amen. But we see that his nurse had took him up, and because Saul had been killed, Jonathan had been killed in battle, amen. And usually, always, that when the king was killed, all his family was killed because they were predecessors to the throne. They would have stepped into his place. But Mephibosheth, his nurse, took him up, and she was afraid that they would be coming to kill him. And she was running. She was afraid. She was running with him. Amen. And she made haste to flee. That means she was in a hurry. Amen. And he fell. And he got crippled up in both his legs, and he became lame, and his name was Mephibosheth. We see that he became lame in both his legs. Now, all of us in here, we were lame when we were born, because we were born into sin.
Right.
We were born after the similitude of Adam, amen. We see that he was down in a place called Lodibar. Say Lodibar.
Lodibar.
Amen. I like the way some preachers say it, Lodibar. That is Lodibar. But in Lodibar, amen. He was down in Lodibar, and it's a place with no pasture. It's a dry place where there's not much to eat. There's no place to run your herds and your cattle. And you know, that could be where you're at today. You could be in a dry place in your life right now. You could be in a place called Lodibar in your life. You could be in one. You could be in a place where you feel so far away from God that you can't even see Him, feel Him, hear Him, touch Him. You could be in a flat place right now in your life.
Yes.
Anybody ever been in Lodibar?
Amen.
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 It's hard to get out of that dry place.
Amen.
Amen. When you're spiritually speaking, when you're in a dry spiritual place, it's hard to get out of there. But you have to encourage yourself in the Lord.
Amen.
Because you're not lame in both feet. If you're saved and you know Jesus Christ, you can stand up. You can rise up in the power of the Lord, and you can walk out of Lodibar.
Yes.
Amen. David had to sin. He had to send people from Mephibosheth. Amen. Because he couldn't get up out of Lodibar. Amen. But you and I can through the power of the Lord.
Amen.
If you're in a dry place, the King has sent for you.
Amen.
The King being God, the King being Jesus,
Amen.
The Holy Ghost is calling you out of that dry place.
Amen.
Because God to live in that dry place. He does not want you to stay on the backside of the desert. He wants you to be rejoicing. He wants you to be filled up. He wants you to be in a place where you can graze in green pastures. He wants you to be in a place where you have happiness and joy and peace in the Holy Ghost. Amen. He wants you to be in a place where you can rejoice. I look out over the congregation, I see many people that are not in a place of rejoicing. You can look at your pastor. I'm not always in a place of rejoicing. Oh, I can paint a smile on. But I'm not always in a place of rejoicing. Many times I go for weeks at a time down in Lodibar. Many times I go for weeks in Lodibar in a dry place in my life. Lord, what are you going to have me to preach next Sunday and I don't hear anything? Lord, what are you going to have me to preach tonight? Lord, I don't hear anything.
Come on.
Lord, I pray. seen him move yet. And I just, oh my, you know I'm dry and things are starting to crumble. And many of us have been there, haven't we?
Right.
Amen. I guarantee we will all go back there. Because we're not always in luscious green pastures, spiritually speaking.
That's right.
Amen. Sometimes we are in Lodabar, but God wants us to come out of there. Amen. I want you to realize that Mephibosheth here, he would not have been a child in our text. We see him as a baby, don't we? But you look on into verse number 12 and you'll see that he had a son named Micah. Okay? He was little when he got crippled up, but in our text here, he's not a baby. He's a grown man because he's got a child. Amen. Maybe you learned something there. I hope so. Amen. Because the Word of God teaches us if we will pay attention. Amen. Oh, thank God. We see that we don't want to be crippled up in sin. We don't want to be crippled up in both feet. Amen. Because God's got good news for you today. That you don't have to stay in that dry place. Amen. That rain is coming if you'll allow it to come. Now you can stop it from coming. You can stop the spiritual rain from falling in your life. You can stay in that dry, depressed place. You can stay in that place of despair and, oh, woe is me. You can stay in that place of fear. You can stay in that place of contentment. You can stay in that place, amen, where you've grown complacent. You can stay there, but God wants you to get on the move. God wants you to get out into the spiritual atmosphere. God wants you to get out where you can get some rain in your life.
Amen.
Some water. Some living water. Amen. Oh, we see that all of us in here, who in here has sinned? Who in here is going to sin? Oh, we see, amen, that all have sinned, have we not? The Word of God tells us, amen. The Word of God tells us that we have sinned and come short the glory of God. It tells us, amen, that we've come short, but also tells us that we can be redeemed.
Amen.
We can be redeemed. We can't. How can we be redeemed? Redeemed simply means to be purchased with a price. And we know that we have been bought with a price. We are not our own. We've been bought with the price of Jesus Christ's blood. We've been bought with the price of Christ. Amen. This body is the temple. And guess who's dwelling in it? The Holy Ghost is dwelling in it. Amen. You've been bought with a price. You have been redeemed. If you know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, you can be redeemed. We see Mephibosheth being redeemed. Amen. He'd been called under the king's palace. No doubt that he had a little bit of fear in his life. Well, they're just going to kill me because I'm successor to the throne. Really? Saul? Jonathan? Dead? He would have been the next in line. Oh, but we see, amen. Oh, that he may have had some fear. How many of us had fear?
Amen.
Amen. Some of us still live in fear. But we see, amen, that the Bible tells in Romans 5:19, for as by one man's disobedience, which is Adam, many were made sinners. So by the obedience of one shall many be made righteous. The obedience of Jesus Christ is what makes you and I that know Jesus Christ righteous.
Amen.
Amen. Many shall be made righteous. You're not righteous in and of yourselves. It's only by grace alone. Amen.
Amen.
What's it going to say? Moreover, the law here that the offense might abound, but where sin abounded, what's it say? Grace did much more abound. Thank God for grace. Amen. Thank God for grace. You say, well, I don't sin. I know people say that. Well, I don't sin. How many of you in here drive? Most people in here. How many of you in here speed? I'm way up here. They allow me 5 miles an hour, right? If it's 70, that means I can do 75. If it's 35, I can do 40. That's not the law, is it, Dave? The law says 70. And you know what? As Christians, we are supposed to obey man's law.
Amen.
Oh, boy, this is going to hurt. So when you get out here and go down 81 or 91 or 58 and on the way home today and you're doing 68 or 78 or 88, amen, guess what? You're in sin.
Amen. That's right.
Because you're breaking man's law, which we as Christians are supposed to follow. But thank God for grace. Because where sin did abound, grace did much more abound. And thank God it wasn't just then, it's now too. Oh my, that should have had you swinging off the chandelier. Amen. Thank God for grace. Amen. We would all go to hell if it wasn't for grace. Amen. If it wasn't for grace, we'd all burn. Because we can't do it. We can't live it. Thank God for grace. Amen. Oh my. We see the word of God tells us all. What's it say, all?
All.
All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of us all. We have all gone astray. And the Lord laid all the sin on Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Woo, what a heavy load he's carrying just for my life. I'm not talking about you or anyone else in the world. I'm talking about just me. What a heavy load he was carrying just for me. But just think of the whole world. Because he carried the whole sin of the whole world. Amen. Oh, thank God that his blood covers all sin. Oh, thank God for grace. Amen. Oh, my. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. All of us have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Being justified freely by his grace through redemption. There, that word is redeemed. Redemption. You've been bought with a price. Through redemption that is in Christ Jesus. That is how we have been redeemed. We've been bought by that price of Jesus.
Yes.
Boy, that preacher preaches Jesus every Sunday. You got that right.
Amen.
And I will every Sunday.
Amen.
I preach the blood until the day I die. Amen.
Amen.
I'll preach the blood of Jesus because that is the message. Amen.
Amen.
The message is Jesus.
Amen.
That is the good news. That's the gospel.
Amen.
Amen. Thank God for grace. Thank God for mercy. Thank God for love. Thank God for Jesus. Oh, we see that it's only through him. Amen. Oh, that we're made righteous. We see that many times we get off track, don't we? Any of you ever get off track?
Amen.
Other than me? We get off track. How many of you ever run off the road?
Amen.
Thank God for a little rumble strip at side 81. I hit him a lot. I do. Tabby will say, get over there. Or she'll look at me, James, scare me to death. I just, don't tell me how to drive, woman. That's not a proper response, but that is what I generally say. I've been working on that. See, God's still working on me.
Amen.
I know that's not a proper response. But I see, amen, that God is working on me, and I have been redeemed through the blood of Jesus Christ. Because for me to even talk to my wife like that, that's sin. Boy, I knew the women would get that one. Wives, when you talk to your husbands like that, guess what?
Amen.
That's sin. You can respect your husband. He's supposed to respect you.
Amen.
We see. Thank God for grace. Because we can't. Oh, the Sunday school lesson this morning, it went right along with this. Amen. We have to be doers of the word, not hearers only. We can't live by the law, because if we try to live by the law, we are going to be found guilty. Because if you offend in one part of it, you done failed. You done failed the test. Oh, that's what I preached on last Sunday. Oh, I remembered it. Imagine that. Amen. We see that we can't live by the law because we can't live good enough. Because if you offend at one point, you're guilty of it all. The Sunday school this lesson, by the way, about this morning, by the way, for those that missed, it was on showing respect to people. Showing respect to other people. Showing preferential treatment to others. You know, if we are to show respect to anyone, it's to those of the household of faith. The Word of God says that. Amen. But when we look at someone and we look down on them and we judge them, how many of us judge people? How many of you judge me today? Amen. To be honest, I mean, as soon as you saw me, you judged me. You formed an opinion in your mind. David couldn't put it no better. That's the nature of people. We judge people as soon as we see them. That's the way we do. But we see when we do that, the word of God is very clear over the book of James. It tells us that when we do that, we are in sin. It doesn't say maybe you are, it says you are, and you've already violated the law, so guess what? You're in sin. You might as well broke all of it. Amen. Oh, that was such a good lesson. Oh, but to get back on point. And then we see that people will be questioned, won't they? You'll notice here Mephibosheth, his loyalty to David will be questioned on over in the Word of God. Those of you who take notes, you better write this down. Amen. Over in 2 Samuel 16, 1 through 4, David, he takes everything away that he had gave back to us. But then you look over in 2 Samuel 19, 17 through 30, and you'll see where he gives it back to him, because you'll see David was lied to. Amen. We see that people will always call you into question, won't they? How many of you, somebody lied on you? Oh, you didn't raise your hand. Guess what? You just don't know it.
Get you covered.
They kept it covered. That's right. Amen. We see that, thank God for grace. Amen. Thank God that our loyalty may come into question. Amen. But praise God, He knows our heart.
Yes.
He knows where we are. He knows where we stand.
Amen.
What did Job say? The Lord knoweth the way that I take. He knows. Amen. God knows the way that you go. God knows where your heart is. Now, you may sin and you may get caught up in some things, but God knows where your heart is.
Yes.
Look at David. He's a man after God's own heart. A just man, what? Falleth seven times, but rises back up again. We see, amen. God knows your heart today.
Amen.
How many of you ever failed? You're sitting here today, so you didn't stay there.
Right.
You rose back up. And that's what we as Christians have to do, amen. We have to realize we are going to fail God. But through the blood of Jesus Christ, we can succeed. That's the only way. Amen. We're going to come short. We're going to fall short, amen. But thank God for grace, amen. Oh, grace is a dirty word to the devil. The devil wants you to see guilt. Shame. That's what the devil wants you to see. He wants you to be constantly put down.
Right.
Grace is a dirty word to the devil, because grace, for by grace are you saved through faith, that not of yourself. Grace, we see grace all through the Bible, amen. Grace is a dirty word to the devil, because grace, it's the power behind the gospel.
Amen.
Amen. Grace, the grace of God. Amen. Oh, it's the wonder of the gospel. It's a wonder He could have wrecked someone as wicked as I was.
Amen.
It's a wonder He could have wrecked someone as wicked as you are.
Amen.
Well, I'm not that bad. Oh, we done and seen the Word of God told us we were born into sin. So we're all just as bad.
Amen.
Grace is the wonder of the gospel. Amen. And grace, it's the difference of the gospel. No other religion, no other people preach Jesus Christ and grace the way that Christians do. Amen. It separates us. It puts us apart. The grace of God puts us apart from everyone else that's worshiping idols. From everyone else that's looking for other ways into heaven. It's the grace of God that makes the difference. Amen.
Amen.
Everyone else thinks you've got to do this to get in. But it's by grace. It's unmerited. Grace is simply the unmerited, unearned, undeserved favor of God.
Amen.
We don't deserve it. We definitely didn't earn it. Do we deserve it? No. We didn't earn it. Amen. And it's unmerited, because God does it. Why? Because He loves us. Amen. Why does He extend His grace to us? Because He loves us. Amen. Oh, thank God. Titus 2 and 11. For the grace of God that bringeth salvation. The grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to everybody. Unto all men, women, boys, girls, children, everyone sitting in here today. The grace of God hath appeared to all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. Looking for that blessed hope, grace, blessed hope, salvation. Oh, those all go together. And the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us that he might redeem us. Oh, he bought us again. We're purchased. He's redeemed us that he might redeem us from all iniquity. And purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works. Peculiar means purchased, a purchased people. We're different, amen. Zealous of good works. Are you zealous of good works? Do you desire to do good works? If you're saved, oh, the Sunday school this morning, right on point. It was right there, amen.
Yes.
That if you're saved, it's going to bring forth works.
Amen.
Because faith without works is dead. Amen. When you're saved, you're going to be zealous of good works. You're going to want to do good works for the Lord. You're going to want to do things for God.
Amen.
Amen. Because it will bring that about. Amen. Well, thank God that it will. We see that the work of salvation, amen, thank God, it's for our lives. Amen. But grace is power for our lives. Grace is what gives us power. Amen. We are to be strong. 2 Timothy 2:1. Be strong in grace that is in Christ Jesus. 1 Peter 4:10. Amen. As every man has received the gift, even so minister the same one another as good stewards of the manifold or many, the many ways of grace of God. But grow in grace. Oh my. We've got to grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We've got to keep growing. Amen. We can't just get saved and say that's it. We've got to keep growing.
Amen.
Amen. To him be glory both now and forever. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. Oh, thank God. We see that grace is all through the Word of God. We need to grow in grace. Amen. We need to be good stewards of the manifold graces of God. Amen. We need to be strong in the grace. Oh, you're one of them grace preachers. Yes, I am. Thank God for grace.
Amen.
Amen. I'm not a once saved, always saved. No. Amen. Because if you have accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, are you going to be perfect? No. But thank God for grace.
Amen.
Thank God for mercy. When you do something wrong, you're going to know it because the Holy Ghost is going to convict you over it.
Amen.
Amen. It's only through grace that you can, only through grace that you can be. Oh, my. We see grace is much deeper than any of us even really understand. Grace, the devil would think, have you to think it stopped right here. But grace just starts on the altar.
Amen.
Grace starts at salvation.
Amen.
Amen. Grace goes all through your life. Amen. Oh, my. Thank God. Because grace, it'll enrich your life and enable you and empower you to keep walking a Christian walk. Amen. Oh, and when you do stumble and fall, not if you do, when you do, you'll be able to get back up just because of grace.
Amen.
Oh, thank God. Thank God. Oh, we see, amen, that we don't deserve it. Satan wants you to keep going in your own strength.
Yeah.
But we can't. We can't go in our own strength. We got to have the power of the Holy Ghost, amen. Because, oh, we see, where in the world can we find grace? Where can we find it, amen? Oh, we see that grace, grace is a wonderful thing. Because grace, oh, it will find us. I want you to look here in our text that we read. David, he had just won a great battle. He had just overcome the Philistines and the Amorites. Amen. He had just overcome the Syrians. And he was just sitting down chilling. He was sitting there looking back. If you read the Word of God, it won't say chilling. But you look back. And he was sitting there pondering or thinking back over his life and what he had accomplished. How many of you ever done that? There's a stage of life that we all reach where we sit down and we do that. Amen.
Amen.
We see, what have I accomplished in life? David was these great victories, and he was thinking about all he had done, and he remembered a promise that he had made to Jonathan, Saul's son. He had promised that he wouldn't forget the house of Saul. He wouldn't forget Jonathan's house because he loved Jonathan.
Yes,
that he loved him. He loved him as a brother. He was dear. They were dear friends. Amen. And he made a promise he wouldn't forget him. So he got to looking for somebody to show honor to. Because look, here he'd won all these victories. And he wasn't saying, look what I've done. He was thinking about the grace of God. while he was sitting on his throne, pondering his life. He was thinking about the grace of God and all these battles he had won. How many of you have won battles in your life? It might not have been against the Philistines, the Syrians, the Amorites. It might not have been against them. But you've won battles in your life.
Amen.
Through the grace of God.
Amen.
Imagine David thinking about the grace of God that had been bestowed on his life. And then he remembers that promise he had made to Jonathan to remember his house. And then he called Ziba. He called to see if there was anyone left that he could show grace to. Oh, my. We see, look at verse number 3 of chapter 9. And the king said, is there not yet any of the house of Saul that I may show the kindness of God unto him? And Ziba said unto the king, Jonathan hath yet a son which is lame on his feet. Now I want you to know, he was sure to point out that Mephibosheth was lame on his feet. Because there wasn't anything that Mephibosheth could have gave David. He was lame. Lame people would have been set outside and have been begging. That would have been it. Mephibosheth had nothing he could give David. David called on him not for what Mephibosheth could give him, but for the grace that he could bestow on Mephibosheth.
Amen.
God, our King, calls us not for what we can give him, but for what he can give us.
Amen.
Oh my, see the practical application of the Word of God?
Yes.
Our King calls us not for what we've got, but for what he's got to give us.
Amen.
Oh my, that is good stuff. Amen.
Amen.
Thank God for him calling us. Because the Holy Ghost could be calling you today. You could be laying on both feet and somebody pointing it out. Remember, your loyalty is always going to be questioned. Mephibosheth was, Ziba's was, Ziba lied. When you go over and read that, Ziba lied. Your loyalty is always going to be questioned. But we see, amen, that God's grace is sufficient. God's grace, he wants to bestow it on you today.
Amen.
He doesn't want you to be in Lodabar. He doesn't want you to be in that dry place. He wants you to come into the green pastures, amen. Oh, thank God. We see that he wanted to show kindness, amen. Oh, thank God that he did. Because grace, it's going to find you. Grace will find you, and it's going to find you first, amen. But God commended his love towards us, and that while we were yet sinners, who died for us? Christ died for us.
Amen.
Grace found you first.
Amen.
Grace is looking for you today. You may not be looking for grace, but grace is looking for you because God wants you to be saved. God wants to change your life. He wants to bring you out of Lodabar. He may be calling you out of the desert and a dry place of sin today. If you're in sin today and you're lost, I know you. Amen. There's no doubt in my mind that he is. Amen. Oh, thank God that grace remembers us. Do you know grace remembers you? God knows when you need a little more grace.
Amen.
You know that? Remember, grace did much, or sin abounded, grace did much more abound. Remember, God knows when you need a little more grace. Oh, there's different kinds of grace too, but that's a whole different message, amen. There's sustaining grace, there's saving grace, amen. Oh, there are all kinds of it. We see, amen, that God, his grace is sufficient. His grace, he's calling you, he remembers you. God knows your name today.
Amen.
You may not know all the people in this church, but God does.
Yes. Amen.
God knows everybody's name in here, and he knows exactly what you're thinking right
yes.
now. Amen. He does. God's grace remembers you. And thank God that it does. Amen. Look at Mephibosheth. He had been forgotten by everybody. He had been forgotten by the nation. He had been forgotten by everyone. Amen. His family abandoned him. There's no point to remembering. Amen. But we see God's grace, it started in the throne room. It started with David. Amen. Remembering Mephibosheth. Just like God's grace for us. Amen. It starts in the throne room of grace. Amen. Oh, and it works its way down to us. Amen. It remembers us where we are. Amen. It remembers no matter where you're at. Thank God. Oh, because God doesn't need us. We need him.
Amen.
God does not need you. We need him. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, thank God. Thank you, God. Thank God that his grace is, he's got no motive behind it. It's just pure love.
Amen.
For for you and me. Amen. It's pure love. I'm glad that grace, amen. You see, the Lord is not slack concerning his promises. Some men count slackness, but his long suffering to us, we're not willing that any should perish, but what, that all should come unto repentance. God, he doesn't want anyone to go to hell. Do you want anybody to go to hell? If you do, you're not in the will of God. Because God does not want anyone to go, but he knows there's going to be a whole lot go. He does. But remember, it's appeared unto all men. The grace of God which bringeth salvation hath appeared unto all men. Mm-hmm. Remember that scripture? This is key stuff. This is good. This is key. Crucial. Biblical truth.
Amen.
Amen. God is long-suffering. Thank God he suffered long for me. He waited on me for a long time. I should have gotten saved a whole lot sooner than I did. Amen. June 26, 2002, thank God for the day that I got saved. He was long-suffering towards me. Some 13 or 14 years ago, amen, praise God. He was long-suffering.
Amen.
Oh, my. Thank God that he is long-suffering, because how many of us in here is a bunch of old hard heads? We are. We're hard-headed. We are a stubborn and stiff-necked generation. We are. We're stubborn. We're hard-headed. We're set in our ways, but God is long-suffering to us. He doesn't want anyone to perish. Amen. Oh, thank God. I'm glad that grace does remember us. I'm glad that grace follows us.
Amen.
You know, how in the world does grace follow us? Well, you ask the prodigal son. Amen. He was walling in a pig pen, eating with the pigs. He was eating the husk. Grace followed him. Bible says when he come to himself, when he got his head together, when he come to himself, he realized, amen, that his father would welcome him back. He wanted to go back as a servant. He wanted to go back. But no, his father was standing there with open arms, with grace.
Yeah, come on.
Then come on back, son. Amen. He put a robe on him. He put a gold ring on his finger. He killed the fatted calf. They partied. Amen. He was glad to have his son back.
Amen.
Amen. Grace followed him all the way to the pig pen, just like grace followed me and you all the way to the pig pen.
Yes.
Oh, my. You ask Joseph. Amen. You ask Joseph. Grace followed him into the pit that his brothers threw him in.
Right.
And grace followed him so far that he rose to the second in power in Egypt, right under Pharaoh.
Amen.
Woo! You talk about grace, amen.
Amen.
Praise God, that is grace. You ask the Samaritan woman at the well, amen. Oh my, over in John 4, 13 and 14. And she said, well, you don't even have a, this is paraphrase, you don't even have a bucket to get the water out. Woman, if you knew what kind of water I was talking about, amen, you would want some of it. He said, whosoever drinks this water will thirst again, but whoever drinks this water will shall never thirst. Amen.
Yeah.
She said, well, give me some of that water.